Hello everyone. In today's video, I will continue the discussion on Derendorf. In last video, I discussed how Derendorf differentiated capitalist society with that of industrial society. I will discuss how Derendorf argued that the equality in industrial society is now a practice, is now a matter of practical experience. Over this issue, the Marx pointed out that capitalist society don't have the equality. Capitalist society maintains a clear-cut polarization of bourgeoisie and proletariat, or class conflict that always exists in the capitalist society. And he predicted for socialist society which will be classless, and the equality will establish. So this establishment of socialist society would be the result of the overthrowing of the capitalist regime or domination of the capitalist. But Derendorf found that this has not happened. Rather, the industrial society or post-capitalist society has undergone many changes, and these changes I already discussed in the other videos, and here I just giving you the highlight of all these discussions. He mentioned that the industrial society or post-capitalist society has certain features, that is the decomposition of the capitalist class, the decomposition of the proletariat, that is labor class, social mobility, and the emergence of the white collar professionals. So all these things, all these features proved, according to Derendorf, that the class consciousness among the proletariat is now vanished. There is no class consciousness, and instead of making a class consciousness for class conflict, the proletariat or labor class and the newly emerged middle class are striving for upward mobility or development of their social economic status and equality. So that's why there is no chance of conflict in the industrial society or post capitalist society. So this idea, he continued, that Derendorf continued this discussion, and he said that in the industrial society or post-capitalist society, equality is in practice. That is, practice of equality is found. Practice of equality is being experienced. Derendorf here pointed out that the industrial society or post-capitalist society is having the social equality or citizenship rights. That is, mainly he gave the reference of 19th century, that is from 19th century, the citizenship rights, the issue of citizenship rights that entered into the political arena. That means the universal adult franchise and the freedom of the contesting in the election, or freedom of the formation of political parties and associations and pressure groups helped or started or began a new pattern of the social inequality, or new pattern of the social or citizenship rights in the society. So Derendorf argued that here even those who believes in the Marxist ideas, those who are Marxist, they also even followed this political struggle for the working class. So they got the political rights, they got the political opportunities to form the associations like trade unions and other pressure groups, and even the political parties in different countries, and that helped largely the working class. So this kind of social rights or citizenship rights ultimately are taken away the chance of class consciousness, chance of the class consciousness among the proletariat for class conflict. Rather, people started receiving the social rights or citizenship rights. Derendorf also took the reference of the Frankfurt School thinkers like Horkheimer, who pointed out that the commodities of culture industry ensured or provided certain mode of spending life, leisure, or the recreational activities and many such things which peoples received, imbibed happily. There is masses imbibed all these commodities of culture industry happily, and peoples are now striving or trying to get these facilities in life. So ultimately Derendorf's point is that this industrial society or post-capitalist society is more towards the equality. There is equal competition and equal opportunity. But this particular question of equal opportunity also got criticized by Marx. The Marx before pointed out this particular point, there is equality. According to Marx, this equal opportunity or equality was just a myth, because this equality means equality of buyers, equality of the sellers. That means the commodities are available which are produced by the capitalist, and you have the equality to purchase. So he questioned this, because this is just a superficial level of equality which ultimately benefits those who have potential, those who have affluency in purchasing. So this particular point also discussed by Derendorf, but he said that today's industrial society, post-capitalist society, is mainly regulated by the state mechanism of the welfare system, where state provides many and different the citizenship rights or rights of the citizens, or provides different facilities for the citizens or the peoples in the form of the welfare schemes, and these benefits the lower sections to get uplifted and enjoys the equal opportunity or equality. So for Derendorf, in today's industrial society or post-capitalist society, the social stratification and even class structure has no meaning. That means in today's industrial society or post-capitalist society, the class conflict is invisible. Not exactly invisible, means class conflict has not vanished, but the different nature of class conflict has developed. But the class conflict what Marx predicted is not visible in today's time. So it's a different kind of class conflict, that is class conflict related to power and authority. But he again pointed out that in today's society, equality is in practice, that is peoples are getting equality, equal rights. So social stratification for him and class structure for him, that is for Derendorf, is not that destructive or not that disruptive in today's society. But this particular point needs to be analyzed critically for better understanding of the contemporary society. We the researcher of the sociology, the sociologist must critically analyze, that is whether the present form of the equality or present form of the equal opportunity and present form of the reciprocal relationship among the classes is actually making the masses beneficial, masses the uplifted, masses developed, or it has some other implications. Because if we relate this particular point with the ideas or theories of the Frankfurt School, they pointed out that the industrial society or post-capitalist society has a different kind of domination called domination of ideas. There is ideological domination, domination of ideas, ideological domination or domination by the rationality. So this point I will discuss in any other video. This needs to be analyzed critically. So here point is that equality is in practice in the industrial society or post-capitalist society. But Derendorf has not denied the existence of class conflict, but he said that the nature and the form of class conflict has changed. Now today's society has a different nature of class conflict that is based on power and authority. So that we will discuss in the next video.